Dear viewers, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to show how to create a .NET Core Web API and how can I call this API from .NET Core Web Applications using jQuery Ajax. First, I will create an API project. After that, I will create a .NET Core Web Application and I will show how to call this API from this application. So let's create API. Select ASP.NET Core Web Application. Just next. Core API. Example. Just create. And select API, and here I am using ASP.NET Core 3.0. Just create. In the controller folder, you will find weather forecast controller. There is the default controller created by default. I will create another controller. I'll select API controller, empty, and add. Give a name. I'll create products controller. And I'll create a folder model, and I'll create a class product. Product ID, okay, product ID, product name, and price. Launch settings, I'll change. Here we will find the weather forecast controller that running by default, and I will change this as products. And API slash products. What that's this, whenever I run this project, it will run using this controller. I'll create a method. Thank you. this project. This product list will be found if I call product. If I call this method get by ID, it will provide ID. Product this ID is 1, it will return. If I change the ID, it will return the second ID. Okay, the API creation has been done. Now I will create a .NET Core web application and I will call this API from this application. For that I create another application. Web application. Okay, project creation done. I will get PU model controller option. I'll use index in here. From here I will call this API. By using jQuery Ajax I will call this API. For that I have to add a jQuery file, my project. Service URL, the URL of API URL. This is the URL. Ajax calling VS Code. Control product. Service URL will be the URL, and I have called this Ajax with get method. URL will be the this URL, and it will return data, and I have filled a table using this data. Create this table, product ID, name and price. Product ID, name and price. Okay. And finally, call this function. This application, it's written error. If I so console. Access to XML HTTP request from origin has been blocked by cross policy. No access control allow origin. Header is present on the request resource. To avoid this error, we have to access origin. For that, in API we have to write some code. In startup .cs file, run this API. Okay, and from web application, can run this application. Okay. if we want to debug. Startup will find. Return this. We'll get this data from API. And this data is from API.